In this video, I'll show you how to create a photorealistic render in Blender. I will try to recreate this photo of a car parked in the roadside somewhere in the mountains. The image is from Unsplash and was taken by photographer Colin Lloyd. First off, I imported an image to work as a background in Blender. The background image is from Pixabay and is free to use. I imported it as images as planes and set it up to cover the background. Then I added an HDRI from Polyhaven to the scene. I chose an HDRI with afternoon sun, just like the original image, to get the same sort of lighting and shadows in my scene. For the road, I used the add-on Urbaniac that contains pre-made urban 3D models like streets, sidewalks and buildings. The road was ready to use with a click and it had the same two yellow lines as the original photo. Now for the car. I used the add-on transportation for this task. It has a wide range of pre-made cars to choose from, and luckily it had a Lamborghini Urus, the same as in the picture. The color was not the same, so I had to adjust it. I also had to adjust the texture of the windows to make them look less transparent. For the trees in the background, I picked some from the add-on Botanic. They were not quite the same as in the original image, but this was my best option at the moment. Then I added the snow as a cube, but I was not satisfied with the look and later deleted it again. There are some shadows on the asphalt in the original picture and it seems like some people stand outside of the frame. Therefore, I added a 3D model of a man from the add-on Blender kit. I duplicated him to make three different shadows. While working on the scene, I adjusted the HDRI to make the shadows in the right angle. Then I imported a plane with snow from Blender kit and placed it in the background. It was better than my previous attempt. During the creation of the scene, I changed the camera angle several times. I was just eyeballing the perspective, but you could use an add-on like F-Spy to be more precise. Then I rendered the image and in the compositor, I set some color grading. It was hard getting the colors to match perfectly with the original image. It was okay, but not fantastic. So I used Photoshop to get the colors closer to the original. I missed the color of the car and the original is a bit darker gray than my version. It took around 45 minutes in real time to create the scene. Here is the original picture and here is the one from Blender. I hope you found this useful. By the way, did you know that you can use ChatGPT to create add-ons for Blender? In one of my other videos, I show you how, and you get a link to download the add-on for free.